Hi everyone, this is Diego Martin from Bespoken. And next, in our series of videos with Dabble app, today I'll show you how to completely test your voice apps with our end-to-end tests.
Up until now, you've seen how the Bespoken Tools CLI can help you speed up your programming and keep the quality of your code in check. But as a voice developer, you know that a voice app is made up of more than just code. You need to pay attention to your interaction model and test that the platform of your choice can understand correctly what a user is saying and turn it into intents and slots. Here's where our end-to-end scripts will help you. By turning your test scripts into audio and calling directly the Alexa or Google Assistant voice services, you'll be sure that your interaction model was configured properly, that the infrastructure of your voice apps is working correctly, and that there are no speech recognition issues whatsoever in any language that your voice apps are available. Sounds good? Let me show you how that works.
First, I'll need you to go into apps.bespoken.io/dashboard and create a new account for the Bespoken dashboard. You can either register with your email and password or log in with Amazon, Google, or GitHub.
The Bespoken dashboard is a platform where you can centralize your voice app testing efforts, but for now, we'll only use it to create a virtual device for our tests.
And what exactly is that? A virtual device is just like a physical Amazon Echo or Google Home, just that you'll be able to interact with it by using our test scripts and not your voice. Also, a virtual device will have access to any voice app that your account has access to, including the ones in the development and life stages.
Go into the virtual device tab and create a new one for your preferred voice platform. I'm going to go with Alexa. As you can see, we'll ask you to give us some permissions in order to create it. But don't worry, Bespoken won't be able to access your voice app code or interaction model and won't save the content of your future scripts. Now that it is created, see the token field? That's the key that we'll use to identify and make use of your new virtual device. Click here to copy it. That's all we need from the dashboard right now.
Before I forget, if you haven't been keeping up with our videos, the voice app we'll be working on is a simple fax skill called Space Fax, where we'll ask for a random fact of any member of our solar system, like the Sun, Moon, or Mars. And if you haven't already, this is the perfect time to install the Bespoken Tools library. Simply open a new terminal window and type npm install bespokentools-g. Once that is done, just open the code editor of your preference and let's create the following structure. A file named testing.json at the root level. A folder named test. And a YAML script inside of it called spacefax.e2e.yaml. The testing.json file will store global configurations for all of our tests. We'll start by setting up the type and set it to E2E to differentiate it from the unit tests. Then we'll set the virtual device token property. For this, just paste the value that we copied from the Bespoken dashboard. Next, in our YAML file, we'll start by adding a configuration section. And just like last time, we'll set the locale to US English. It is important to follow the YAML conventions here. And remember that each section in a file starts with three dashes. Our next section will contain our first test. We'll set a name for it, in this case, launch and no further interaction. And on the next line, we are going to write what we would usually say to invoke our voice app, followed by the message or part of the message that we are expecting back from it. We can continue with another test. I'm going to create a new section. I'm going to call this test launch and ask for help. And what we are going to do is to open the voice app again. We are not going to do an assertion on this first line. Then we're going to ask for help and we expect to get back, what can I help you with? Now stay with me as I write the equivalent of the tests we did in our unit test video. If we do a quick comparison, the biggest difference between this file and our unit test script is that we are now able to write down the utterances directly as we would say them, instead of writing the intent names and the slot names. Alright, I think that's enough of writing tests. Let's open a new terminal and try them by typing BST test. As you will notice, the test times have gone up from what we had with the unit tests, but that is to be expected, since we are no longer emulating Alexa or Google services locally, but using the real ones instead. What we have gained is the certainty that the whole infrastructure of our voice app works as it should. Now that it has finished, you can see our tests have succeeded, and if you want to check really quick if your voice app was reached for real, you can do so by going into the Alexa or Google history pages. I'll leave the links down below.
Open space facts.
Oh, and before I forget, I went back to the script and added two errors on purpose. You can see here that they are listed in the test execution summary once you've run the BST test command. But besides that, a new folder called test output has been created, and inside of it, you'll find a nice HTML report. This is how it looks. As you can see, we have a nice visual summary of your results, and you can filter them at the top so that you can quickly see any errors on your tests and react accordingly.
Wasn't that easy? From here, you can test your voice apps with our scripts anytime that you want, and be sure that it will always provide a pleasant experience to your users. We strongly recommend integrating our tools into your continuous integration tool, like Travis, Circle, or any other one, so that any change that you make to your voice apps is always tested in its entirety. And that's it. If you found this helpful, please like this video and subscribe to the channel, where you'll find over 120 other Alexa and Google Assistant development tutorials. And if you have any questions regarding the Bespoken tools, feel free to reach out to us at bespoken.io. Thank you, and see you soon.